Hello everybody, welcome to my Let's Play of Super Mario Bros. 3. This game is actually my game and I am very excited to be playing it with you all today. If you have ever played one of my games you would know my games are freaking awesome. So without further ado let's jump into Super Mario Bros. 3. The first level of Super Mario Bros. 3 is probably my favorite one because it's so simple and it introduces you to the core mechanics of how Super Mario Bros. 3 plays. It's the beginner level but it is still super. That is one of my favorite things about Super Mario Bros. 3 is that some levels can be simple and others can be super hard but they are still fun. On to the next level. In the next level things start getting pretty serious. This isn't level 1 anymore, where is the pink to the big leagues. You have to really figure out how to use the ramp button for this level or you won't get anywhere, so make sure to hold up the button so you can ramp better than that to put Sonic GUI. This level also introduces the ton of lift that makes you look like a skill. Even though it is curte it is also deadly because you can spin your enemies or you can fly super high into the air. After that we move on to the third level and this is where we are introduced to Goombas coming out of the pipes, one of my personal favorite enemies because usually you only see them doing regular things but now they are going through pipes like crazy men. In this section I will also be attempting to get the P-Suit to go to the secret coin room where I can get a lot of coins so that can turn into life so I never die. It's a bit tricky but I think I will be able to get it considering this is my own game. There we go. I have done the impossible and got the P-Switch. Let's see what is inside of here. Guamama. Wee. That was so much fun. I hope I can do it again later because it was just so much fun. This is the card room. Here Toad is going to give us something awesome from one of his chests. Toad is a very nice boy and that is why he helps you in the game, thank goodness he isn't rude like that old copa Bowser. If Bowser was trying to give me something in a chest he would not open it because he is evil. Now on to the fourth level, this level is the first level where it is moving on its own, as you can see I have no control over this beast because the level wants to move on its own. Having the level move on its own you never know what is up ahead so you have to be very careful and make sure you don't fall off, be very patient and strategic and that will get you through this level. The enemies are not as much of a problem as they are in the other levels so this one should be a breeze if you are comfortable with the level moving on its own.